Western Christians are rich, developed, and progressed, and they look down on the Hindu, Muslim, and Buddhist. And the Muslim consists of over 40 countries, and the Buddhist over 10 countries, and the Hindu just appear. Nobody there to challenge against the Christian. Only the Muslim there to challenge against the Christian.
Muslims don't have the guts, and I am a person who is not very much in favor of politicians. There are very few politicians who I respect, and one of them is Tun Dr. Mahathir Mohamad. And I remember when I met him the first time several years back in Abu Dhabi, we were discussing, and he said that if the Muslims, if the Arabs stop dealing in dollars, America will come on his knees immediately. There are few politicians who I really care. One was King Faisal of Saudi Arabia. He had the guts. I remember when you read his biography that when oil was discovered, he said, let's have the meeting in the desert. And that time when they pressurized the Muslims, King Faisal said that we are Badus, we are Bedouin, we are Arabs, we can go back to the desert. What will happen to you when we stop giving you oil? And I believe one of the things of Dr. Tun Mahathir Mohamad was that if he had the control of the oil, what the Arabs had, he would have ruled the world. That's why I said in my lecture of terrorism Muslim monopoly that most of the terrorist acts directly and indirectly are related to politicians. They try and create the World Bank, they create all this problem. In Islam, we do not believe that we should look down upon one another based on caste, color, or creed. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Hujurat, chapter number 49, verse number 13, Ya ayyuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha wa jalnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu innakum min Allah yatqakum inna Allah alim khabir. O humankind, we have created you from a single pair of male and female and have divided you into nations and tribes so that you will recognize each other, not that you shall despise each other. And the most honored in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the person who has taqwa. The criteria for judgment in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only way one human being can be superior to the other human being is not by wealth, it's not by color, it's not by creed, it's not by sex, but it is taqwa, it is God consciousness, it is piety.